Hi there, Phil Pendlebury here. Hope you're having a super mega large day and thanks for joining me. So I've got a little tip today that came up on our advanced Cubase users group on Facebook, and trying to explain it was a little bit tricky. So I just thought I'd put it into video mode. It's quite simple. So the question was, is there a way to adjust controller values on multiple MIDI channels all at the same time? And there is a few ways of doing this, but this was one that I came up with that not many people seem to know about. So let's just do it. Okay, so here we are in Cubase 11, and I've just prepared very briefly a little dummy project. There's no need for any audio today because it's just going to be showing you what's going on the screen. Let me zoom in. And as you can see here, I've just made four MIDI channels with three notes and some controller on modulation CC1 here. All right. And as you know, you can select all of those and you can view them this way. Let's get rid of the cameras. So you can see the controller at the bottom there on this particular channel, MIDI 1. There's the piano. There's drums. There's a spade. Don't ask. So how do we grab these controller values and move them all at once? Now, even though I've got all the tracks selected, and that's why they're all showing up separately here, if I want to select the controller, I can move that one like this up and down. As you can see, it compresses itself as well. But if I, let's say, for example, take this one all the way down at the bottom, and then go to the others, it hasn't affected those at all. So here's a cheeky little way to deal with that. So for this, we're going to use the list editor, which is under the MIDI menu. You could have a shortcut set up for this, of course, as well. And there it is. There's the list editor. Once again, let me get rid of the camera now that you can see everything clearly. And the list editor is really powerful, because it will show you pretty much everything that's on whatever you've got selected. So at the moment, it's just one of those channels that's selected. But if I select all of them and go to the list editor, you can see that it's showing all of the values. So there's all the different CC1s. And at the top, there's the notes. And in fact, we can actually select all the notes and move them if we want to. So how do we deal with the CC values? Well, here's the trick. First of all, this is a filter here, so we can hide all the notes. And basically now we're seeing only CCs. You can see that that value there is CC146. And if I hover over the data 2 value, select it, you can see by moving my mouse, I'm actually changing that value. Now, what a lot of people don't realize is if you just do a simple select all, which is Control A on Windows, and do the same thing. So we've selected the value, and then I'm just scrolling with the mouse, and you can see that it's changing all of the values. Now, the only downside to this, if certain value is already down at the bottom, let's say it's at the value of 10, then you can't go any further than that, obviously. But what you can do is basically move all of them at once, and you can even type in a value. So let's say, I don't know, 10, press Control, Enter, and it will change all of them to 10. So that was a little trick. I don't know how useful you'll find it, but who knows, it may be helpful at some point or another. Okay, thanks for watching. See you again.